What's up guys, GeoGebra here. In this video, we're going to continue our series on GeoGebra basics. We will be using the geometry perspective, which we can open using this option here. So I'll just click on geometry and there you go. So in this video, we're going to investigate what happens if we connect the consecutive midpoints of a quadrilateral. So first, we will draw a quadrilateral. Then we draw its midpoints, connect the midpoints using the polygon tool, and see what happens. Okay, so first we use the point tool. This is the second tool in the toolbar. Select point, and then to draw the vertices of the quadrilateral, just click on four different locations on the graphics view. Next, we need to connect the vertices with a segment. So we use the segment tool, click the third tool, and then select segment. Now to connect AB, just click on A and then click on B. Also, if we want to connect B and C, just click on B and then click on C. And of course, we connect the other vertices. Now we have a quadrilateral. If we want to move the objects, we can use the move tool, the first tool in the toolbar or on the toolbar. And we can drag the points. We can drag the segment, of course. We can drag the label. And lastly, we can also drag the window. The next step is to draw the midpoints of each side. The midpoint of each side. So we use the midpoint or center. And then click on two points to get their midpoint, or if it's a segment, you just click on the segment. And there's our midpoint. So what happens if we connect the consecutive midpoints using the polygon tool? So this is the polygon tool. Click on the first vertex, and then click on the other vertices, and to close the polygon, click on the first vertex again. And there you go. Now what happens if we drag the vertices? What can you observe about the polygon? It seems like the polygon is a parallelogram. And how do we verify that? Well, we can use the angle tool. And then click on the center of the polygon and see what happens. Now, if the quadrilateral is a parallelogram, the opposite angle should be congruent, meaning the measure should be equal. So this is a parallelogram. What if we move the vertices? This one, is it a parallelogram? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's 119.73 and then 60.27. Okay, so how do we know that it's indeed a parallelogram every time? Of course, we have to prove. But that's not our lesson. Our lesson is about how to use the different tools of GeoGebra to construct the inner quadrilateral. So to have a brief review, we have learned how to use the point tool, the midpoint or center tool, the segment tool, the polygon tool, and the angle tool. I hope you have learned something from this tutorial. I would like to invite you to subscribe to my channel and invite your friends. Like our videos and comment if you want. See you.